Before I get started, I want to give context for this video. I'm currently working on a big in-depth analysis video of the Sonic movie trilogy plus the Knuckles TV show, and I already released a sneak peek of that giant video. And originally, I was not going to make the Knuckles review a separate video. But you know what? I decided, why not? As sort of a sneak peek of what you're going to see for the entire Sonic movie trilogy video. And so without further ado, here is the wasted potential of the Knuckles show. The Knuckles show was so bad it made me puke. Twice. Okay, but in all seriousness, the Knuckles show, it's not very good. And I had high expectations since the last two movies were very good, but man, it wasn't it, but let me explain why. Before I talk about anything negative about the show, I actually want to start with something good. That being the main man himself. Well, kind of the main man, but we'll get into that later. Anyways, the main man himself, Knuckles. But before I talk about Knuckles, I want to talk about the build-up to the show and why it was disappointing. So, let's go back to 2019. On April of 2019, Paramount Pictures released the first trailer to the first ever theatrically released Sonic the Hedgehog film. A Sonic movie was many fans' dream, and we got this.
Meow?
And the fans were furious. The whole internet was clowning on Sonic's design. And so, Paramount decided to delay the whole movie by a year and completely change the design. And people loved the new design. The movie was released on February of 2020 and was met with critical and financial success. And the redesign basically saved the movie. Fast forward 2 years later and we got a sequel featuring Knuckles, Tails, and an accurate look of Eggman. And more video game worlds in the sequel, which many fans wanted. I say that because in the first movie, the only things that were video game related was Green Hill, Sonic, Eggman, and the Rings. Although the first movie was not bad by any means, it was just a simple buddy comedy film with very minimal things Sonic related. So the sequel went bigger and better with more Sonic characters and worlds. And at the end of the second film, Shadow was teased for a third movie. So the build-up for the Knuckles show is great. Tons of people, including myself, expected to see more Sonic-related things in the Knuckles show, due to the track record of the film so far being progressing into the movies being more like the games. Since the show was going to take place between the second and third Sonic movies, people were wondering how could this build up into the highly anticipated Sonic 3. And well, it did none of that. It didn't feel like it was building up to the third movie at all. In fact, it didn't even feel like a Knuckles show. And that's why I felt so disappointing. So to start off why the show was so disappointing, now let me talk about the main man himself, Knuckles.
Your society is full of soft and undisciplined weaklings. However, I do enjoy the planet's grapes. The grapes are delicious.
Knuckles is... he's okay in this show. He doesn't really grow as a character because, well, he's not really in this show, and he doesn't really have anything to do. Even though this is his show, see? His name's right there on the poster. Is he entertaining to watch? Yeah, but that's not really a compliment to the show because, well, he's not really in it that much. Knuckles in the second Sonic movie was a great character. We see his backstory in the sequel through Knuckles telling Sonic about it, which shows Sonic maybe he's not just some angry echidna looking for power. He actually has a heart and is a very conflicted character, and I really liked that from the second Sonic movie. I would have really liked to see more development of Knuckles' backstory because it was teased in the second movie. He has such an interesting backstory in the game, so seeing it in a TV show would have been very interesting. But that never happened. And even though it's a Knuckles show, he doesn't really get that much development.
We see in episode 1 that Knuckles is confused and wants help from his echidna elders, which is where we see the ghost of Patchkamak. He tells Knuckles that his quest is not completed, but has only just begun. He has a new quest, a new journey to become a warrior, to become Knuckles the Echidna. So what does Patchkamak say to Knuckles? To find Wade and train him. When I first watched this scene, I didn't really care. I was like, yeah, that's the plot of the show. I guess that makes sense. But now when I rewatch the scene, this makes no sense at all. This makes no sense for either one of the two characters, and let me explain why. Why in the world, for Knuckles to honor his legacy for the Echidna tribe, his next quest to be a warrior is to train Wade Whipple to win a bowling tournament. Look, I like the concept of Wade training someone to become a warrior. It's a really cool idea. But do you know who's a better character to be in Wade's position for Knuckles to train? It would have made a lot more sense not only for the Sonic universe, but to Sonic fans. Tails. Tails is a very smart character, but isn't physically strong. And we've seen in shows like Sonic Boom that he can fight, due to him having a lot of experience. So why not Knuckles, with the strength and the knowledge of being a warrior, trains Tails to not only fight with his gadgets, but be a warrior. Not only would this make sense for both the characters, but it would help build their friendship and not feel like your time was wasted going into Sonic 3. I think it could have been like a younger brother, older brother scenario with Tails and Knuckles, and it would have made the final battle more impactful. And like I said before, it would make the show in general not feel like a filler gap between Sonic 2 and 3. We could have seen how and why not only Knuckles appreciating Earth, but the people around him. Due to him training Tails, and I really wish we got that. So, I was pretty excited to see a show about Knuckles. To see his backstory and him learning to appreciate Earth and the people around him. Too bad that's not what we got!
It is I, Wade Whipple, your long-abandoned progeny.
Wade in the Sonic movies, he was just kind of there. He was in a couple scenes and that was it, and I never really cared about the character. Does the show change that? No.
Future me here, Wade as a character has kind of grown on me. A lot of the points in this part of this video I still stand by, but Wade as a character has kind of grown on me. Mostly because of
the flames of disaster!
But before I kind of didn't really like Wade Whipple as a character to now really enjoying him.
Wade was a small comedic character in the movies to now the most developed human character in the Sonic movie universe, and let me explain why. The main plot of the show is Wade and his family and him trying to win a bowling tournament while trying to find his long lost father who abandoned him in TJ Maxx. Yes, that is the real plot of the show, and man, I couldn't care less about the story to be honest. The first two episodes was where Knuckles was trying to get used to Earth by bonding with Wade. It was actually really entertaining due to Knuckles knowing a lot about being a warrior and not Earth, and Wade knowing a lot about Earth but not being a warrior. It would have been a really interesting duo throughout the whole show, but then we get into episode 3. And everything just falls apart. And yeah, episode 3 is easily my least favorite of any of the episodes from the show, and honestly, that's saying something because most of the show is pretty bad. The whole thing with Knuckles having dinner with Wade's family was one of the worst things I've ever seen in a Sonic-related thing ever. I was just sat there thinking, well, what the f*** am I watching? It felt like a weird Sonic fanfiction. Although this action scene was pretty cool. The ending with Wade telling Knuckles that he has a home is nice on paper, although it's very similar to the first Sonic movie, is not very satisfying because, well, half the show, they're not even together. This story would have been completely fine if it was a small bad sitcom on Paramount Plus, but this is a Knuckles show, aka a Sonic spin-off show. Sonic fans really don't care about Wade and his family. Well, most of them. I mean, there's probably some Wade fans out there. And it's not even done well. There are 6 episodes, and half of them, Knuckles isn't even in them. Because the show is focused on Wade, and maybe I would have at least appreciated the show if the main story was done well, but it was really, really, really boring. But does this complement the Sonic movie universe well?
No.
The short answer is no. Even though Sonic 3 is not out by the time I'm writing this, you could probably skip the show and nothing would change at all.
Something I also found really funny was the end credits scene. It's a trend for the Sonic movie franchise to have an end credits scene after the movie's finished. With the first movie being...
If these readings are accurate, he's here. I found him. I just hope I'm not too late.
I'll be home by Christmas.
And the second movie being
Project Shadow.
So I wasn't really expecting much for an end credit scene for the Knuckles show, but maybe a little hint for Sonic 3. Maybe seeing what Sonic and Tails are doing, maybe see a little clip of Shadow. But nope, this is what we got.
Hey Knuckles! How about some new road trip music? I call this mix Knuckles and Wade Warrior Jammers.
What is this amazing song? Could this be? Yes! This is my jam!
And I'm gonna be honest, it's not a bad scene. I actually quite like it a lot, but I was expecting more of a leading up to the next movie type of end credit scene, like the last two movies. I don't even know if there are cool little Easter eggs, but if there are, I really don't care, to be honest. Future me here, I actually do remember some Easter eggs from the Knuckles show. It may not be all of them, but here's the ones I remember. I remember in episode one, Knuckles does the little spin thing in the ground, or the spin attack in the ground. And then in, I think it was episode 4 or 5, he has his hat. And then, I think it's episode 2, the agents go to this, I think it's a hotel or something. And then it has a name of a popular level from one of the Sonic games. I don't remember what it was called, but I think I'll put it on screen here. And of course, how can I forget? But yeah, those are all the Easter eggs I missed in the Knuckles show. If there's any I missed, please put them down in the comments below.
Looks like you're all out of balls!
In the Sonic movies, Eggman and Agent Stone are smart, funny, and entertaining villains. And obviously, the Knuckles show probably won't have the same villains as the Sonic movies. So I was very curious of what they will do. Could they bring Rouge the Bat, Metal Sonic? Because they obviously can't bring Shadow, because that's for Sonic 3. Maybe some characters from Sonic Lost World, maybe Cubot and Orbot, who knows? Maybe they'll try to make this villain more entertaining and funny than Dr. Eggman. But they didn't do that. Fuck. The villains, and I'm gonna be honest, not all of them are bad. Are the Eggman and Agent Stone level good? No, but they're definitely enjoyable to watch. The Buyer could have been a great villain, but he's barely in the show. He had a lot of potential with having all the weapons and gadgets in the show, and also previously working with Robotnik.
I used to work for Gunn as well. Though it wasn't called Gunn back then. It was a military shadow ops program run by a difficult and very brilliant roboticist.
Wait, so you worked for Robotnik?
I did. Until the day he met a little blue alien, lost his big, bald mind. After that, Gunn tried to erase all connections with Robotnik, including me. Sent a team to take me out. That didn't work out so well for them. So I went underground, starting selling my creations in the black market. Before you know it, had built an empire.
It could have been a genuine threat to the characters, but instead we get a generic, boring villain. The CGI fight at the end with no development or screen time whatsoever. So I guess the main villains are his henchmen, which honestly, I do kind of like both of these characters and their dynamic.
You think you can take my power?
Do I look like I need your power?
What are you talking about? Of course we need his power. It's the whole reason we're here.
You could tell Kid Cudi was having a blast in the show, which is good because I really do enjoy his character. And the other one, which I can't remember her name for the life of me, but you know, she's a decent character too. Their gadgets are pretty cool, and I like how they use the portal rings. And the final battle was fine, I guess, whatever. I don't have anything else to say about the villains. Let's just move on. I'll keep this short and sweet. The animation is great for the most part. I was expecting to look like the Sonic Drone Home short, but no, it's actually on par with the movies, which is really impressive. Now, I don't know what the budget is for this show, but what I do know is that it was definitely used mostly for the copyrighted songs. Why are there so many pop songs in the show? Why? Why did you do this, Paramount? It was just so unnecessary. Why? You know what would have been better for the show for songs? Sonic Sean. Wow. Sonic songs. Sonic Sean. I cannot say this. Sonic music. Yeah, Sonic. You know what would have been better for the show for songs? Sonic music.
Here, I'm gonna show you a couple scenes from the Knuckles show with the original song and then songs from the Sonic the Hedgehog games, and you tell me which one's better.
What is this amazing song? Could this be? Yes! This is my jam! What is this amazing song? Could this be? Yes! This is
I jam.
Here I come, rougher than the rest of them, the best of them, tougher than leather. You can call me Knuckles.
All right, Wade's awesome rescue plan starts now. Step one, project confidence. All right, Wade's awesome rescue plan starts now. Step one, project confidence.
This is a problem I have with even the movies. I just don't understand why they don't use Sonic music in this franchise. Sonic has one of the best video game soundtracks of all time, and I don't really understand why Paramount either barely uses it or just never does in these movies. And this show is loaded with pop songs to the point where it kind of just gets annoying. Also, what is with all the product placement in this movie? Doritos, TJ Maxx, fucking Facebook Marketplace? Alright, let me just talk about the rest of the characters. Alright, let me talk about the good characters first. Sonic, Tails, and Maddie. They're the same as they usually are, you know, great entertaining characters, but it's too bad that they're only in one episode. I also find it funny that Tom's not in the show. They say in the show that he's out of town, but it's most likely because they couldn't afford the actor that plays him. Which means since Tom's out of town, that makes Wade the main police officer for Green Hill Zone. Hey, wait a minute. Wade goes to a bowling tournament with Knuckles, so who's the main police officer of Green Hill Zone? Oh my, I'm done with this show.
I'm done.
Now on to the bad characters. Wade's family. They're either extremely boring or just downright awful. First, there's Wade's mother. I mean, you know, she's there. I have no problem with her character. She just, you know, very one-dimensional, very boring, just not really that interesting. Wade's father, I think, is some famous bowling player or something. I don't know. I don't even remember. I think he turns out to be a twist villain or something. I don't know. I don't care. And then there's Wade's sister. Basically, Wade's family are not great characters, and since they're the focus, that makes the show pretty bad. Well, yes and no. I think a genuinely good Sonic show in this universe can work really well, and Sonic has translated well in television before. I think Sonic Prime is a hilarious and fantastic show, so Sonic in TV can work really well. And a Knuckles show could have worked really well, but there is just so much wrong with this show. I don't really know who this show is for because when it comes to the humor, there are just some jokes like this.
What is this sorcery? Wade? Wade?
And then there are some jokes like this.
Just do it, man.
I'm actually
like, who was this made for? There's a lot of potential for multiple Sonic movie shows, like a Shadow or Tails or Eggman show. It would all be very interesting. But if this is the route they're taking for Sonic shows, then stop while you're ahead. And before I move on, I want to talk about the best thing in this show. No, I'm not talking about the credits. I'm talking about the best episode in the show. Because yes, there is something good about this show.
You are grounded!
I have no idea what that means.
It's episode one. Episode 1 is the best episode. Why? Well, it actually shows what I kinda wanted in this Knuckles show. Knuckles is trying to adjust in his new life on Earth with his new friends. And there's actually some funny parts of this episode. This actually gave me hope for the rest of the show because I thought it would've just been more of episode 1, with Knuckles learning how to appreciate Earth with his new friends, but nope! In general, the Knuckles show is incredibly disappointing and bad. I feel like Knuckles and Wade building up to becoming friends could've worked, but most of the time, they're not even on screen together. Which makes the finale very underwhelming. It's sad because there were tons of potential because of the endless possibilities of the world of Sonic in film and television. But this just wasn't it. Hey, Future Me here, and I just want to kind of just jump in and just talk about that Paramount TV Studios shut down, and that kind of leaves me with a bunch of questions of the future of the Sonic movie shows. Now, I don't know much about Paramount TV Studios shutting down. I didn't even know that even existed, to be honest, but you know, I saw this all over, you know, I saw a bunch of news articles and I saw all over Twitter, and I was just kind of confused of what the future will be for a lot of these Sonic movie shows, because they're, you know, made by Paramount and they're on Paramount Plus. even though there's only one, but that's what I will assume the future shows would be. But now, since this is kind of shut down, I don't know what's going to happen. This also probably doesn't mean a Knuckles Season 2, which I'm pretty happy about, but that also makes me wonder if there's going to ever be like a Shadow TV show or a Tails TV show. I don't know. I have no idea. Maybe you guys could inform me in the comments below about like what they will do for future Sonic shows, or maybe news about Paramount TV Studios or any of that, because I don't really know about this whole situation. I just want to kind of just talk about it and sort of the future of Sonic shows and what will happen, and maybe like the future of a Knuckles Season 2, because I don't really know. But if you guys like know anything or know any updates about this whole situation, please let me know, because again, I don't know anything about this, and I'm just kind of, I have a lot of questions of what will happen with, you know, Sonic shows. Well, preferably Sonic movie shows, mostly. Because even though I didn't like the Knuckles show, I'm still open to Sonic movie shows. I think that's a really cool idea. But I don't know if that will happen in the future. I give the show a 2 out of 10. Not a very good show.
You should be ashamed of yourself,
Paramount.
Anyway, if you like this video, like, comment, favorite, subscribe, retweet, reblog, tickle my balls. Born on an island in the heavens, the blood of my ancestors flows inside me. My duty is to save the flower from evil deterioration.